Monday morning, let's get Monday drunk.
Ooh, another Simo crack.
Simo crack.
Oh, whoa.
Wow, who? Dude, BrewDog has become.
Did you pick this?
Yeah.
This is good.
I literally, anytime I see a BrewDog can that's different than what I've had, I get it.
No kidding.
I don't know what it is about like the matte finish of the cans. This one's got like a good gradient from yellow to orange. I don't know, man. I really think their beers are great. This is a Tangerine Session IPA.
This is tasty, tasty. What's it called there?
Clockwork Tangerine.
That's some good stuff, man.
Yeah, I dig it. 4.5%. A lot of these recipes were kind of created overseas in Scotland. See?
How it says born in Scotland, brewed in the USA.
Mm-hmm.
Either that or the guy who brewed it was born in Scotland.
He was born there,
and
so technically the ideas don't have citizenship here.
Does BrewDog usually have like movie themed, like Clockwork Tangerine?
Maybe they do.
Clockwork Orange.
Maybe they do. And I haven't even noticed.
Now tell me what you had in mind, Georgie boy.
Either way, this is really, really good.
It's really good, man. Their beer is so great. BrewDog, I really want to know you. To get to know you. Alright guys, today very special lineup of sauces. I used to live, if you can believe it or not, in Jacksonville Beach, Florida, and that's where these sauces were made. One of the first companies I first started doing video marketing, I reached out to them. I was like, I really want to make you videos. I just like, I use your sauces on everything. This is the sauce that's on like every diner table in Jack's Beach.
Ooh, Jack's Beach?
So today, Howler Monkey Hot Sauce. This was born kind of in like the Panama area. The guy that does it lives in Jacksonville Beach, Florida. And I'm very excited to finally kind of profile these on the show. This was the hot sauce that got me into hot sauce.
That's awesome.
I had only ever had like the basics, like Cholula and Tabasco and Sriracha. I never had anything else. This made me start branching out. So this was the gateway drug of hot sauce for me.
No kidding? Yeah. Like heroin.
Right. Like heroin.
We're starting off with Howler Monkey Sauce, the original.
Yeah, the
this
OG.
This is the OG. It's got some, it's saying it's a traditional Caribbean style hot sauce.
Yeah,
which is unique to Panama,
right.
Called Aji Chombo.
Right.
Which sounds like that would be a song by Chumbawamba.
It would. Tub Thumpin' was one of their main hits.
Yep. I get no doubt,
and then all the songs sound like a Howler Monkey from National Geographic.
Aji Chombo, that's cool, man. I'm excited about this.
These are Howler Monkeys.
Those are loud animals.
Chumbawambas?
Yeah. All right, Howler Monkey Original.
Cheers. Oh yeah, that's good. This is another very good original.
In like Jack's, I got a lot of tacos. Like I oddly have a really good taco scene in Jacksonville.
No, I can see that.
Taco Lou, my favorite place. I can't wait to go there.
It's got the spot.
I'm actually visiting Jacksonville for the first time since I moved soon. I put Howler Monkey all over this baby.
Oh yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, this is good. It's got a little bit of a kick. I've said it before in videos and I'll say it again. Not usually a big original fan.
Yeah.
But I like when original flavors stick out to me. That says something to me.
I know.
And this is like a really good, like original flavor you can always kind of tell. It's kind of always like, this has got that distinct original flavor, but there's just something a little extra about it.
I know.
It's a little bit more flavorful. And honestly, a little more kick than I usually get from originals.
It does have a
decent kick.
I know, that's really what I really liked about it was like, my palate, and we've talked about this, is so shot now with like heat. I think even from the like the origins of me liking hot sauce, that is hot for an original.
Yeah, for an original, that's got some really good kick.
So that's what I was having with my eggs in the morning.
Yeah.
I bought a case of that. Yeah. I was that guy in my apartment.
And it's still not too much that a regular Joe can't go grab it and still enjoy it.
I agree.
Because regular Joes,
yeah,
they can't handle heat very much.
Sometimes. No, they can't. They're not like regular Sean's and regular Corey's.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, shouldn't we like learn by dodging balls that are thrown at us, or?
That's what this sack of wrenches is for.
If you can believe it, Corey Wagner, which I bet you can, this is the first ever green sauce I ever had too.
Oh, okay, this one right here?
Mm-hmm.
This is the Howler Monkey Verde.
Yeah.
Okay.
I had never had a Verde before.
Verdes, you know what, they can be rare to come by if you're in the right circles, you know? So when you finally find one, you gotta hope you like it.
Verdes traditionally use green bell peppers.
Okay.
And I'm excited to see how this holds up over the years.
Cheers.
Oh yeah. It's really good, man.
Mm-hmm.
They really do hold up.
Mm-hmm.
I was
That's
worried
a really
that like,
good Verde.
Since leaving Jacksonville like 6 years ago, I've had 5 million hot sauces. They really are so
no,
good.
No, this is very good.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, especially for a Verde.
No, that is really good.
That's really good. That's one of the better Verdes I've had, for sure.
I think so too.
No doubt about it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Kind of like the original, I feel like sometimes we're not big verde guys.
No, I think it's also kind of traditionally more of a more boring taste.
Yeah.
When you like heat and you like ghost pepper and you like a lot of cayenne. But that's like really salty.
Yeah, yeah, that. I was trying to figure out what the flavor is that I like. That is the salt. That is so good.
Dude, sodium for the win, bro. People still say FTW or am I just boring?
Quit boring, everyone.
Holy smokes, that's really good. And I can already feel more of a kick than the original, which has more of a kick than I'm usually used to.
Right.
And I feel like Verdes generally have almost no kick.
100%.
Yeah, that's definitely, this is one of the top Verdes I've had for sure in my whole, in our whole career doing hot sauce.
Oh, I know.
Dang, dude.
This next one I'm really excited for you to try.
Okay.
So this came out to be the original for people who are like, I have original on everything. I wanted the same kind of flavor, but ramp it up a little bit. That's what this is.
Oh,
this
cool.
is the Amarillo, which is yellow in Spanish. Scotch bonnet peppers. So it's a little bit more of a spicy pepper than what the original uses.
Okay.
And it really does look yellow. It's like highlighted.
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is the Amarillo.
Cheers.
Yeah. Mmm. People really be sleeping on Scotch bonnet peppers, dude.
Dude, no doubt.
I think they're
no
so
doubt.
Good.
No doubt. They're so good. And they definitely have this like yellowish color comes with those scotches for sure.
Mm-hmm. Mmm. You look good in the Scotch bonnet.
Mmm. Damn, dude, this is really good.
Terrific. Like, for being very vinegar-based.
Which like, I usually hate.
Vinegar-based can get kind of like, oh, everybody does vinegar-based. When they're done with this much flavor, you're like, oh, okay.
Yeah, no kidding.
I'm gonna sop that up with some chips.
Perfect, like, progression. In terms of like the heat's getting just a little bit hotter tick, every time.
Tick, 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 yeah.
And man, that is definitely that next level up.
It really is.
That's really, really, really tasty stuff. Oh my gosh.
Now this last one, you can see like the pepper flakes on the wings from us pouring it on there. This is their hot. So the peppers they use in the hot, habanero pepper mash. So it's that like, and red Scotch bonnet peppers.
Oh, cool.
And then a bunch of turmeric, which we love. This was the one that was like, oh wow, I like spicy food. Like,
yeah,
that's how I knew. Cheers.
Cheers.
God dang, dude.
Good flavor.
Oh, it's really good.
All these have unique flavors and they're all really good.
Yeah.
Like sometimes you'll get a company that all their flavors are kind of similar.
Mm-hmm.
Not this guy.
Mm. I'm relatively certain that Hot Ones, maybe last season, used a Howler Monkey sauce.
Oh, I hope so.
Which to me was so crazy.
Taking over the beloved, no big deal slot on the board is Howler Monkey Original on the tangy, vinegar-based hot sauce category. The first pitch of the game is just a fastball right over the plate. Strike one.
That was so good.
Dude, isn't it great?
Is that their highest heat?
That's their highest heat. I don't think they make another one. I think they just make those four. I don't think they've ever done like a really insane Reaper one or anything.
That's perfect though. Honestly,
I agree.
If I'm trying to enjoy myself, like I get it trying to like sometimes be like, I'm gonna see the hottest thing I can eat.
Right.
But when I'm actually trying to like have something enjoyable on food, that's almost exactly like, I feel like that's the perfect amount of heat.
I agree.
That's exactly the level I want to reach where I'm like feeling it.
Me too.
But it's not ruining, I feel like I can keep going. But if I eat 10 of them, I'll be like, I need to stop.
For sure. Dude, I told you.
You guys hit it out of the park. That was, every single one of those was super unique, super flavorful.
Yeah.
The right amount of heat for what it was providing and delicious.
And Howler Monkey, if you're seeing this video, I'm actually in Jacksonville right now. So if you're watching this on the week of November 11th, I'm in the city for the first time in 6 years. So I will be eating your hot sauce at every restaurant I go to. Can't wait to see Don and Debbie at Taco Lou because they're my homies. So it's gonna be a good week, man. I'm excited.
That sounds like it. Holy smokes, this is great. I feel like it's been a while since I found a brand that I'm like really, really enjoying.
I know.
This is,
I know. Bam, 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 good.
Patreon shout out, Patreon shout out, Patreon shout out. Ladies and gentlemen, it's still rolling for a little while longer. We got our special offer for you.
Woo! Cheers, 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 cheers. Bam, 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 bam.
That's right, so for the small, measly price of $5, that's right, if you sign up on our $5 tier until November 26th, we will be sending you guys two sticker sheets, that's a value of $10, and also a handwritten note from myself as well as from Sean. And we're gonna try to make them pretty funny, we're gonna have a good time with them, we're gonna like try to throw in little things that we know about you guys
for sure.
All the comments that you say and like the relationship we built together over the past few years. So really, we've talked about it a couple times, we're both really excited to like actually send letters to you guys. It seems like something really fun.
I want you to be my pen pal forever.
I know, right?
Yeah, 100%.
So we're really excited about it. We're already gonna give it to anybody who's currently signed up for $5 or more.
Yeah.
So if you've been signed up for that, don't worry about it, it's coming your way. And anybody else who's interested in getting like, it's gonna be like right around kind of coming up on the Christmas time. If you're interested in getting a letter from Sean and Corey, sign up for that $5 tier and we'll send you guys our little essentially kind of a thank you note for supporting us.
Patreon.com/number6withcheese. Sign up. If you're one in $3 and you want to bump it up, just click that $5. It'll update you. You're good to go. It's your first time having these. You got to pick your favorite, hot, amarillo, verde, or original. Eric McCluskey, our drummer, who just sits off camera. Drum roll, please. Thank you, sir. You know which one you want?
Yeah, I think so. I think so. you never know what to do for these.
So three, two, one. I'm so glad you like the verde. Amarillo is still my favorite. I thought it was, and it still is.
That's probably my favorite, but this is just the best verde I've ever had, so I had to snag it.
I get it.
But you're right. That is such a good one, man. All of these.
Up for it, man. You know what? Jack's Beach, baby. I had a good time living there, man. I made a lot of videos in Jack's Beach. That place knew me, bro.
Knew me.
You know where else I can't wait to go?
Steve's Beach.
Maple Street Biscuit Company.
Oh, just got biscuits.
It's a breakfast biscuit, like skillet platter situation.
Oh, that sounds good.
It's still, I live in Chicago and I miss it. I have the best breakfast ever here.
Yeah, dude, right?
Oh, but you know what I will say, the South, I know Jacksonville people don't think it's the South. They do, it's like Georgia basically. I think the guy that started it was like from Nashville or something, or from Tennessee. And it's, dude, I've been dreaming about it for
weeks. You ever come in your pants from dreaming about it?
I mean, I don't want to tell these folks what I've been doing.
That was uncalled for.
Well, Corey, you know what? I gotta go ahead and disappear because I'm in Jacksonville right now. And you know, if you can do the math, this isn't Jacksonville, so I need to leave to be in Jacksonville.
Yeah, but before you leave.
Sure! I'll have a drink.
Hit him up in Jacksonville.
Wait, stay right there. Stay right there.
See ya.
Stay right there.
Bye.
Don't move.
Ow.
Don't move. Stay right there. Don't move.
What the? Hey, come back! Don't stay in Jacksonville forever! Where are you? Where are you?
Do you have something shiny Jason can play with?